सो हाय गाइस, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस, इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नाबार्ड। एंड गाइस, टुडे सेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द बायएनुअल डिजिटल इंडिया अवार्ड्स 2020। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन सो दैट यू कैन रिसीव ऑल द नोटिफिकेशंस रिगार्डिंग द वीडियोस। So let's begin with the very first question. So question number 1 and 2 guys are based on the Digital India Awards. So let's first talk about the Digital India Awards. So President of India Ramnath Kovind conferred the 6th edition of Digital India Awards 2020. So this was the 6th edition and the very first edition was held in the year 2010. Okay, first edition was in 2010, then we have 2012, 14, 16, 18 and this is the 6th edition which is in the year 2020. And guys, these awards have been instituted under the ambit of National Portal of India, which works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT. And Ministry of Electronics and IT is headed by Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. His Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib in Bihar, as we all know. And now these are the six categories of awards. In these six categories, this award has been given. Number one is Innovation in Pandemic. Then we have Excellence in Digital Governance to a Ministry or a Department. Excellence in Digital Governance to a state or a UT. Excellence in Digital Governance to a district. Then we have Open Data Champion. And then we have Exemplary Product. And there is one more category of awards guys, which can be there or which cannot be there. Okay, and that is Jury Choice. Agar Jury ki choice ke according koi agar digital innovation hai, then that digital innovation can get that award. Otherwise, ये कोई फिक्स्ड कैटेगरी नहीं है। सो देयर आर सिक्स फिक्स्ड कैटेगरीज, व्हाइल ज्यूरी चॉइस कैन बी अ कैटेगरी इन वन ऑफ द अवार्ड्स लाइक दिस ईयर ज्यूरी चॉइस अवार्ड्स इज देयर। ओके, तो इस बार कितनी कैटेगरी है? देयर आर 7 कैटेगरीज ऑफ दिस अवार्ड्स दिस ईयर, ऑलराइट। एंड द सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस गाइस वाज डिजाइंड बाय आईआईटी दिल्ली। ओके, आईआईटी दिल्ली ने जो पूरा सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस था वो डिजाइन किया था, व्हिच वाज लेटर असेस्ड बाय द ज्यूरी, ऑलराइट। सो नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द विनर्स। ओके, first of all, in the very first category, that is the innovation in pandemic, platinum award has been given to e-sanjeevani, which we all know is the national telemedicine services, jisne bahut hi acche tarike se kaam kiya tha during the lockdown. Gold award covid-19 sample collection management system jo bhi hai hamare country ka. Then silver mein do awards the aapda sampurti portal. Now this portal guys is of the Bihar government, which is for the disaster management. And Pravasi Shramik and Rozgar Setu portal, this portal is of Madhya Pradesh government, which facilitates the registration and identification of the migrant laborers and other laborers. All right, moving ahead to the next category, which is the excellence in digital governance to a ministry or a department. So platinum award is given to e-committee Supreme Court of India for facilitating the e-courts project. And this project guys is for digitizing the judiciary in our country. Then gold Department of Post for digitizing all the counters of post and the back-end operations of the Department of Post. Then we have silver Department of Fertilizers for providing direct benefit transfer for providing subsidy in a DBT mode. All right. Then we have Department of Land Resources. As we all know, government is working towards the digitization of land records. So for that, Department of Land Resources is working very hard. So, and for that purpose, this silver award has been given to the Department of Land Resources. All right. Moving ahead to the next category, excellence in digital governance to a state or a UT. So platinum award is given to Haryana government for their Saral portal. They have a portal which is known as Saral portal. So Saral portal kya hai basically? So Saral portal pe all the government schemes are available, through which a person can get all the information related to all the government schemes of the Haryana government and the central government as well. All right. Then we have gold award which has been given to Tamil Nadu government for various digital innovations. Then Uttar Pradesh ko isliye mila because Uttar Pradesh Food and Civil Supply Department ne jo digitization ka work kiya hai in the procurement and supply of the food grains. Okay, so Uttar Pradesh Food and Civil Supply Department has got this silver prize in this category for digitizing the procurement process, for digitizing the distribution of food grain. All right. Then West Bengal has got this prize for its supply chain management of the beverage alcohol of the medicinal alcohol. All right. मेडिसिनल एल्कोहल एंड अदर नार्कोटिक ड्रग्स। सो बेसिकली एक इनका प्रोजेक्ट है जिसमें एंड टू एंड जो सप्लाई चेन मैनेजमेंट है उसको वो डिजिटल मैनर में वर्क करता है फॉर द सप्लाईज ऑफ बेवरेज एल्कोहल, मेडिसिनल एल्कोहल एंड अदर नार्कोटिक ड्रग्स, एंड फॉर दैट वेस्ट बंगाल हैज गॉट दिस प्राइज। एंड मूविंग अहेड टू द नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी विच इज द डिस्ट्रिक्ट कैटेगरी। सो प्लैटिनम अवार्ड इज गिवन टू खारगोन डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश, देन गोल्ड चंगलांग इन अरुणाचल प्रदेश, देन सिल्वर कामारेड्डी इन तेलंगाना, एंड ऑल ऑफ देम गॉट दिस प्राइज फॉर डिजिटाइजिंग द सिटीजन सेंट्रिक सर्विसेज। ऑलराइट, मूविंग अहेड टू द नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी विच इज द ओपन डेटा चैंपियन। सो गाइज, ओपन डेटा चैंपियन उन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को, मिनिस्ट्रीज को दिया जाता है विच आर वर्किंग फॉर द डेटा मैनेजमेंट। ऑलराइट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल प्लैटिनम अवार्ड हैज बीन गिवन टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर विच हैज वर्क्ड अ लॉट ड्यूरिंग द पैंडेमिक। गोल्ड अवार्ड रिसर्च डेटा मैनेजमेंट इन ICAR, देन सिल्वर अवार्ड FCI, वी ऑल नो फूड सप्लाई के लिए, एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ माइक्रो स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेस को भी मिला है फॉर द डिजिटाइजेशन ऑफ MSME सेक्टर। ऑलराइट, एंड नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द एग्जेम्पलरी प्रोडक्ट्स, Port Community System PCS-1X, which is nothing but a National Maritime Single Window, which can be accessed by everyone. Gold के लिए Service Plus, Service Gold Award जो है, that has been given to the Service Plus. Then we have Silver, Integrated Temple Management Service, through which a person, through which a devotee, can get all the information related to a temple through this portal. Alright. And next, then we have jury choice, the final category. Number one, we have Arogya Setu. We all know about Arogya Setu. And then we have a e-office, which is basically एक online system है जहाँ पे Indian government के सारे offices का address वगैरह सब कुछ access किया जा सकता है. This is basically a portal on which all the government offices, their address, their location, their contact number can be assessed. All right. So that is all about, guys, the Digital India Awards. Now let's move on to question number 1 and question number 2. So you have to consider these statements regarding Digital India Awards and identify the correct statement. So teen statement hai, among them you have to identify the correct statements regarding Digital India Awards. So these awards are organized biannually under the ambit of National Portal of India, which works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT. Yes, this is absolutely correct. There are 7 categories under the award. Yeah, guys, you can say that there are 7 categories, but actually there are 6 categories. So let us look at the option, then we will decide. The first edition of awards were held in the year 2005. So no, that is not in the year 2005, that's in the year 2010. So, agar aapke option mein aata hai that yes, there are 7 categories under awards, so you have to mark it right. Okay, ye correct hoga because yes, 2020 mein 7 categories mein award diya gaya tha. Alright, so first and second statement are absolutely correct, which means option B, only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. Alright, question number 2, which of the following states was not conferred with the Digital India Awards 2020 under the Excellence in Digital Governance category? So, 4 states ko mila tha, number 1 Platinum Award Haryana, then we have Silver Gold Award Tamil Nadu, Silver Dothe Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. So, Madhya Pradesh is not one of them, option E, Madhya Pradesh will be the correct answer. Okay, and now guys, let's move on to question number 3. Okay, so question number 3, guys, again is very important because this award has been given to a very famous personality who won the Eminent Engineer Award 2020 instituted by Institute of Engineering and Technology. So there is one Institute of Engineering and Technology which gives this award, which is known as Eminent Engineer Award, and for this year, that is for the year 2020, that is for the 2020, this award has been given to Mr. V.K. Yadav. Alright, Mr. V.K. Yadav. And who is he? He is the chairman of Railway Board and also the very first CEO of Railway Board. Okay, so he is the chairman and CEO of Railway Board. And this is the first CEO. Isse pehle CEO ki post was not there in the Railway Board. Alright, now let's move on to question number 4. Recently, the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, who is Mr. Harshvardhan, has reviewed the status of Kala Azar in India. Kala Azar, guys, is also known as black fever, and it is caused by a protozoa which is known as Leishmaniasis, which is of the genus Leishmania, and it is transmitted by the sand flies ki madad se transmit hota hai. Okay, so iske status ka review liya hai Dr. Harshvardhan ne. So the disease is more prevalent in 4 Indian states. So there are 4 Indian states जहां पे ये डिजीज ज्यादा प्रिवेलेंट है. सो द क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट वन ऑफ दोज स्टेट्स, उनमें से इनमें पांचों में से कौन सा वो एक स्टेट नहीं है जहां पे ये डिजीज प्रेवलेंट है. राइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस न्यूज. डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन हैज रिव्यूड द स्टेटस ऑफ काला अजार इन आवर कंट्री एंड देर आर 54 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स. ओके, देर आर 54 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन फोर स्टेट्स विच आर बिहार, झारखंड, यूपी एंड वेस्ट बंगाल. बिहार, झारखंड, उत्तर प्रदेश एंड वेस्ट बंगाल, इन दीज फोर स्टेट्स दिस डिजीज इज मोर प्रेवलेंट एज कम्पेयर टू द अदर स्टेट्स. अदर स्टेट्स में गाइज मतलब जो भी थोड़े बहुत केसेस है वो बहुत स्कैटर्ड है और बहुत कम है. सो द गवर्नमेंट इज फोकसिंग ऑन दीज फोर स्टेट्स ओनली एंड अदर स्टेट्स लाइक असम, हिमाचल प्रदेश, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, केरला एंड उत्तराखंड हैव द स्कैटर्ड केसेस ऑफ काला अजहर और द ब्लैक फीवर इन आर कंट्री. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द रिव्यू, एज ऑफ 30th November 2020 ओनली 12 ब्लॉक्स इन झारखंड एंड 4 ब्लॉक्स इन बिहार. ओके, 12 ब्लॉक्स इन झारखंड एंड 4 ब्लॉक्स इन बिहार हैव रिपोर्टेड मोर देन 1 केस पर 10,000 पॉपुलेशन. पर 10,000 पॉपुलेशन पे एक केस से ज्यादा केवल 12 ब्लॉक्स इन झारखंड एंड 4 ब्लॉक्स इन बिहार में था. बिहार हैज अचीव द एलिमिनेशन टारगेट इन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द ब्लॉक्स एक्सेप्ट दीज 4 ब्लॉक्स दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हियर. झारखंड टू हैज मेड द सिग्निफिकेंट प्रोग्रेस इन नंबर ऑफ ब्लॉक्स जहां पे एलिमिनेशन का जो कालाजर का जो एलिमिनेशन है वो काफी अच्छा है. देन उत्तर प्रदेश एंड वेस्ट बंगाल हैव अचीव देयर एलिमिनेशन टारगेट बट दे हैव टू सस्टेन देयर प्रोग्रेस. ओके, सो दिस इज द रिव्यू दैट हैज बीन टेकन बाय डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. एंड लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग दैट काला अजहर का जो एलिमिनेशन का टारगेट था दैट वॉज इनिशियली इन द ईयर 2010. दैट वॉज इनिशियली इन द ईयर 2010. Then it was extended to the year 2015. Okay, later it was extended to 2017. But again, we could not achieve this target till the year 2017. And now this target is up to the year 2020, and which may also be extended because we know that 2020 has been ended. So, ab ye target ko aur zyada extend kiya jayega. Although we are working good, we are making a significant progress in elimination of Kala Azhar. But yes, we have not achieved the target of eliminating the Kala Azhar completely. Okay, so these are the targets and currently the target guys is 2020. Okay, so now let's come back to the question. Question was the disease is more prevalent in four Indian states, which of the following is not one of those states? So Bihar, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal are the four states. Punjab is not one of them. Option E, Punjab, will be the correct answer. All right, so guys, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.